Okay, let us turn our Bible to Psalm chapter 20, verses 7 and 8. Psalm chapter 20, verses 7 and 8. Someone can read it in English. Psalm chapter 20, verses 7 and 8.
Some trust in chariots.
Some in horses. But we will remember the name of our Lord God.
They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright.
Amen. Here David talks about trusting God. Today's my message title is Trusting God. Amen. God is expecting us to trust Him in all our ways. Hallelujah. God is expecting us to put our trust completely in God alone. Amen. Here Bible says some put their trust in chariots, some put their trust in horses. But the next verse says, but they were fallen. Amen. But Bible says verse 8. They have bowed down and fallen, but we have risen and stand upright. Amen. The verse 8 talks about the difference between whom put their trust in God and the people who put their trust in chariots and horses. Amen. Whenever we put our trust in God, it will help us to stand straight. Hallelujah. We will never fall when we put our trust in God. Hallelujah. That's why God is expecting us to put our trust in God. Amen. Psalm chapter 34, verse 8. Psalms 34, 8.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in Him.
Blessed is the man who trusts in Him. Amen. If a man put his trust in God, he will be called blessed man. Hallelujah. If a woman put his trust in God, she will be called blessed woman. Amen. Putting trust in God, Him itself, bring a blessing in our life. Amen. Hallelujah. If you have your trust in Jesus, if you have your trust in God, you will be called as a blessed man or blessed woman. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Okay. I want to share about two people from the Bible, how they put that trust in God. Amen. How they overcome the challenges. When they face the challenges, what they did, what the challenges brought their life, because they put their trust in God. Amen. The first man in the Bible is King Asa. 2 Chronicles chapter 14 verses 1 and 2. 2 Chronicles chapter 14 verses 1 and 2. This verses gives an introduction about King Asa. Yeah, we can read 2 Chronicles chapter 14 verses 1 and 2.
So Abijah rested with his fathers and they buried him in the city of David. Then Asa his son reigned in his place. In his days, the land was quiet for 10 years. Asa did what was good and right in the eyes of the Lord his God.
After 10 years, Bible says, the first verse, as Asa his son reigned in his place, in his days the land was quiet for 10 years. When King Asa started his ruling, the first 10 years, there was a peace and quietness and rest. Bible says, he walked uprightness before God. He did good. Amen. Whatever is pleased to God, he did. Amen. Verse 6. We can read verse 6.
And he built fortified cities in Judah, for the land had rest. He had no war in those years, because the Lord had given him rest.
Amen. There was no battle. There was no war. Completely rest. Bible says, during the time of rest, he used the time of rest to build the cities. Okay, the cities with all the safety. He did not waste the time of rest. Amen. In our life also, there are some times we are going through the battle. There are times we are going through the rest, relaxing time. Amen. Hallelujah. But during our time of rest also, we can use it as a time of constructing. Amen. We can use those time of rest to build certain things inside our spiritual walk. Amen. Hallelujah. Many times whenever we have a rest, we want to relax and we don't want to seek God. Amen. Whenever the problem comes, automatically we will start to pray. Whenever there is no problem, automatically we will take break and we will relax. Amen. But this King Asa, he used the time of rest to build the cities, and the Bible says he strengthened all the bars of the gates. Hallelujah. He protected himself and he gave a protection to the people. Okay, verse 7.
Therefore he said to Judah, let us build these cities and make walls around them, and towers, gates and bars, while the land is yet before us. Because we have sought the Lord our God. We have sought him and he has given us rest on every side. So they built and prospered.
Amen. Hallelujah. Why they got the rest? Because they sought God. Hallelujah. The secret for the rest is seeking God. Hallelujah. If you are a person seeking God, then the rest will come and stay in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Why we are going through restlessness? If you are going through the restlessness, if you are going through confusion, that means somewhere we are lacking in seeking God. Hallelujah. If you are a person seeking God with all your heart, definitely there will be a rest in your life. Amen. Maybe the storm around you, but inside your life there will be peace and there will be a quietness and there will be rest. Amen. King Asa had a rest. Not only King Asa, the people of Judah, they had rest. The King Asa said, the secret of our rest is because we sought the Lord. Amen. This evening God wants to encourage us to seek him with all our heart. Amen. So that he can bring the rest in our life. Amen. God wants to remove every restlessness from our mind and from our homes. Amen. Have you ever experienced the restlessness in your life? Sometimes in our workplace, we are going through restlessness. Amen. Sometimes in our homes, we are going through restlessness. Amen. Hallelujah. There are unknown causes. There is no reason, but there is a restlessness gripping our hearts. Amen. But this evening, God wants to remove every restlessness from our life. Amen. Giving rest is the will of God. Hallelujah. How many of you agree with me? Amen. The only key, seek him with all your heart. Amen. When you decide yourself, when you determine yourself, yes, Lord, I'm going to seek your face with all my heart, I believe immediately the rest of God will come and rest upon you. Amen. Hallelujah. King Asa and the people of Judah, they got the rest. Hallelujah. During the time of rest, he started to build fortress. They started to strengthen the walls. Bible says, the Lord prospered. Amen. They prospered. Hallelujah. Amen. When you are a person seeking God, if you are a person seeking God, whatever you do, it will prosper. Hallelujah. First you will have a rest, then it will prosper. You will prosper. Amen. Bible talks about Joseph. The Lord was with Joseph and he prospered. Hallelujah. Even though he was in the land of slavery, whatever he did, it prospered. The reason, he was with the Lord. Amen. He was having the fear of God. Hallelujah. That's why Bible says in Matthew chapter 6, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. When you seek God and his kingdom, then the rest will be upon your life. Amen. King Asa did that. So he got the rest. Amen. Okay, next verse 9.
Then Zerah the Ethiopian came out against them with an army of 1,000,000 men and 300 chariots. And he came to Marisha.
Okay. They were going through the time of rest. Okay. They were building fortress and everything. But all of a sudden, the enemy came to them. Amen. The Ethiopians, nearly 1 million people, they came against King Esau. Hallelujah. Amen. All of a sudden, the enemy came. King Esau was experiencing a rest, but suddenly the enemy appeared. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. But Bible says the next verse.
And Asa went out against him, and he said,
King Asa went out against him. The Bible did not say that Asa scared of the Ethiopian and he ran away from them. Amen. He ready to face the enemy. Amen. If you are a person seeking God, you will have a divine boldness to face the challenges. Hallelujah. You will go against it and you will face it. Hallelujah. Many times in my life, I don't want to face the challenges. Okay. Honestly, I can tell you, I want to run away from those things. Lord, I don't want to face this Ethiopians. I don't want to face this challenge. I don't want to face this enemy. Amen. Hallelujah. But here Bible says King Asa went away to face him. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because he was a man seeking God. Amen. Okay. Verse 11.
And Asa cried out to the Lord his God.
Okay. He took the effort to go against him. But the truth is, he did not put his trust upon his own effort. The verse 11 says,
Lord,
it is nothing for you to help.
Whether with many or with those who have no power, help us, O Lord our God, for we rest on you.
We rest on you. We lean on you. We depend on you. Amen. We put our trust on you.
And in your name we go against this multitude. O Lord, you are our God. Do not let man prevail against you.
Amen. Here he said, we rest on you, and in your name we go against this multitude. O Lord, you are our God. Do not let man prevail against you. Hallelujah. Amen. King Asa confessed, Lord, we want to lean on you. We want to put our trust in you, and we want to go against this Ethiopians. We know that you will help us. Whether we have a power or not, you will help us. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. If you are a person putting trust in God, whether you have a power or not, you will not worry about it, because your trust is in God. Hallelujah. Our trust is not upon our power. Our trust is not upon our wealth. Our trust is not upon our education. Our trust is not in our job. But our trust is in our living God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. If you have a trust in God, you can boldly say, Lord, I know that you will help me. Whether I have all these resources or not, you will help me. Hallelujah. Amen. If you compare with the army with King Asa, the Ethiopians are multitudes. Hallelujah. Nearly double the time the enemies are there. King Asa had only little army, okay, half of the Ethiopian's army, the King Asa had. But still, King Asa confessed, Lord, I am crying out to you. I am putting my trust in you. Hallelujah. In your name, I am going against this Ethiopians. Hallelujah. Amen. What happened next verse? We can see the next verse.
So the Lord struck the Ethiopians before Asa.
So the Lord struck the Ethiopians.
And the Ethiopians fled.
Amen. Hallelujah. Who struck the Ethiopians? The Lord. Amen. Whenever we put the trust in God, He will take care of the battle. Hallelujah. Whenever we put Him first, He will do the battle. Amen. Bible says He struck the Ethiopians and they fled. The next verse is very important. That's the one we need it. In our life also, often the Ethiopians comes and goes. Often the enemies comes, then go back. Then they will come back, right? Often we are facing the challenges again and again. For 15 days, it's a peace. The next half of the month, the challenges. Amen? Then it's like a cycle. Okay, for a time period, it's a peace, rest. Then the second half, battle. Then again battle, right? Again rest, battle, rest, battle, rest, battle, rest. Amen? But Bible says the next verse is very important. When God struck your enemy, what will happen to them? Next verse says.
And Asa and the people who were with him pursued them to Gerar. So the Ethiopians were overthrown and they could not recover.
So the Ethiopians overthrown, not able to recover. They could not recover. The other version says, the Ethiopian once for all gone. Hallelujah. No more Ethiopians in the life of King Asa. God completely struck them. Amen. God completely washed them away. Amen. We need that kind of blessings in our life. Amen. In our life, sometimes we are keep getting the same enemy. Hallelujah. But God wants to struck them and God wants to remove them completely. God wants to overthrow them from our life. Amen. If God struck them, they cannot recover anymore. Amen. They cannot come back anymore. Hallelujah. How many of you want such a victory in your life? Amen. Hallelujah. When you have a victory in your life like this, it will bring a great blessing. Amen. I need such a victory in my life. I need such a blessing in my life. Amen. Hallelujah. We don't want to face the Ethiopians again and again. We don't want to face any enemy again and again. Lord, I want to get rid of this enemy completely. Amen. Hallelujah. Who has to do the battle? God has to do the battle. When God strikes them, they will become. Amen. When God will strike them? When you put your trust in God. Hallelujah. You need to say, Lord, you know, I am helpless. But I believe you are able to help me. Hallelujah. I don't want to see the enemy anymore in my life. Amen. Hallelujah. God wants to clear the enemies from your life. That's why God is expecting us to put our trust in God and in Him alone. Amen. Hallelujah. We can read the next verse.
And they defeated all the cities around Gerar, for the fear of the Lord came upon them. And they plundered all the cities, for there was exceedingly much spoil in them.
They plundered all the cities. Amen. Hallelujah. The enemy came to destroy them. But God turned it upside down. Amen. God struck them and God made them to not come back. Once for all they are gone. But Bible says they plundered all the cities. Hallelujah. Amen. The enemy came to destroy. But the Lord destroyed the enemy. The second blessing, God gave them abundant blessing. Amen. Hallelujah. God wants to encourage you and me. Whenever you are facing the challenges, the double portion of blessing is coming on your way. Amen. Not only removing the enemy, because the enemy disturbed you, he is going to add blessings in your life. Amen. Who can do it? Only God can do it. Hallelujah. Unnecessarily, my people went through this distress. So I need to remove the enemy and also I need to bless them. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. So the challenges become a blessing for King Asa and for the entire people. Hallelujah. Amen. Are you facing your challenges in your life? Or are you facing Ethiopians in your life? Or are you facing a threatenings in your life? Fear not. Very soon, God will remove the enemies. They will not come back. And also, God will bless you with the new blessings. Amen. So far, King Asa did not experience that kind of blessing. Amen. These are the new blessings. They plundered all the cities. Amen. And the next verse.
And they also attacked the livestock enclosures and carried off sheep and camels in abundance and returned to Jerusalem.
Lot of livestock. Camels, sheep. Amen. They came back to Jerusalem with a much joy and a harvest. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Within few days, everything's changed. Hallelujah. two days before or one day before, the prayer of King Asa was different. Hallelujah. The path which King Asa went through is completely different. Amen. Must be there was some distress upon his life, tension, right? But over the night or over the few days, everything changed. Hallelujah. God brought a joy into the city. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 God wants to encourage you. If you are facing a challenges in your life, very soon He will bless you with a double portion of blessings. You will see a new blessings in your life which you did not see so far. Hallelujah. Amen. You will come back safely to your hometown with much blessings. Amen. Because the only one reason King Asa put the trust in God. Hallelujah. This evening, God wants to encourage every one of you here. Do not look into your enemies. Look into your God. Do not look into your challenges. Put your trust in your God. Hallelujah. He will do the battle for you. He knows how to remove the enemy. Hallelujah. Once for all, He will clear the enemies from your path. Amen. That's why the Bible says in Exodus, you will not see the Egyptian anymore. The Egyptian which you are seeing today, you will not see anymore. Hallelujah. Amen. Because God is able to strike all the Egyptian army into the Red Sea. How many of you believe that? Amen. Hallelujah. The Pharaoh thought he will catch the people of God. Pharaoh came after the people of God. But Bible says the Lord did the fight for the people of God. Hallelujah. That's why God completely destroyed the Pharaoh and his army into the Red Sea. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Bible talks about Exodus chapter 15. When they crossed the Red Sea, the other shore, there was a great joy and praises. Amen. Miriam and all the ladies, they take the tambourine and everything, they started to sing and praises. Amen. They faced the challenges. They faced the Red Sea. Hallelujah. But over the night, everything's changed. Hallelujah. Amen. Weeping will be in the evening. The joy will come in the morning. How many of you believe that? Amen. Very soon, very soon, very soon, your stress, your distress will be go away. Amen. If you believe, you will see the glory of God. God is expecting you to put your trust in God. Amen. Hallelujah. King Asa had 10 years of experience. Right? He knows how to fight everything. But he did not put his trust upon his experiences. He put his trust upon God. Hallelujah. Lord, I'm going against these people in your name. Whenever you use the name of the Lord, there will be a great victory over it. Amen. Whenever you use the name of the Lord and go against the enemy, definitely there will be a victory. Amen. Because he's Jehovah Nishi. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that? Amen. Because he is Jehovah Jireh. Amen. He is our provider. Hallelujah. He is our Jehovah Rapha. He is our healer. He is Jehovah Shalom. He is God of peace. How many of you believe that? Amen. He is El Shaddai, Almighty God. Hallelujah. Use the names of the Lord. You will see the victory. Amen. Hallelujah. Jehovah Shalom. He will bring peace into your mind. He will bring peace into your home. He will bring peace into your family. He will bring peace in your workplace. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 How many of you facing challenges in your workplace? Nobody? Okay, one or two. Okay, now some people have some boldness to raise. Okay, I'm not going to ask you what kind of challenges you are going through. No. But I want to tell you, if you are having a challenges in your workplace, when you get into the workplace, just pronounce like this, Lord, you are the Jehovah Shalom. I speak peace in my workplace. Amen? You can see a change. Every restlessness, every tension, will be removed from your workplace, you will have a peace of God. What do you need to say? What do you need to say? You need to pronounce the name of the Lord. What is the name? Jehovah? Shalom. Shalom means peace. Jehovah Shalom. You don't need to say Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Rapha means healer. Okay, for the workplace, you need a healing also. But first you need a peace of God. You need to say Jehovah Shalom. Okay, quietly, when you enter into the workplace, quietly say, my Lord is Jehovah Shalom. I will see the peace in my workplace. Amen. And if your family going through the restlessness, when you enter into a house, tell, my God is Jehovah Shalom. I will see the peace in my home. Amen. Are you listening?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Put your trust in the name of the Lord. You will see a great change. Amen. Hallelujah. Here King Asa faced multitude of people, but God helped him. Amen. But I want to share about the second person from the Bible, David. Hallelujah. Shepherd David faced only one man. Hallelujah. His name was Goliath, Philistine. He did not face multitude. He faced only one man. Amen. Sometimes one person looks like a multitude. Have you ever experienced? Sometimes people will tell, if that person goes, everything will be alright. Because of this one person, everywhere it's a confusion. Have you ever experienced or not? Sometimes people will pray, Lord, remove this person. Everything will be alright. Sometimes one person equal to multitude. Here Goliath was one person, but he was a giant. Hallelujah. David also one person. Here one on one they are facing. Hallelujah. David faced a challenge. David faced a giant. Hallelujah. But Bible says in 1 Samuel chapter 17, I think 45. 1 Samuel chapter 17 verse 45, we can read.
Then David said to the Philistine, you come to me with a sword.
David said to the Philistine, you come with a sword.
With a spear and with a javelin.
With a spear and with a javelin.
But I come to you in the name of the Lord.
But I come to you in the name of the Lord. King Asa went in the name of the Lord. King David, the shepherd David, went in the name of the Lord. Amen.
The God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied.
The God of armies of Israel.
Whom you have defied.
Whom you have defied.
This day the Lord will deliver you into my hand.
This day the Lord will deliver you into my hand.
And I will strike you and take your head from you.
And I will strike you and take the head from you.
And this day I will give the carcasses of the camp of the Philistines to the birds of the air and the wild beasts of the earth.
Amen. Hallelujah. David put the trust in the name of the Lord. He went against the Philistine. We all know the story. We all know the story. We all know the end of the story. Even though David did not have any sword and any spear, God gave Goliath in his hand. Amen. Hallelujah. God brought the giant under his feet. If you read the few more scriptures after the few more scriptures, Bible says, David stood upon Goliath and he took his sword and he took the head away from his body. Amen. David stood above Goliath. Amen. God promised you, I will keep you above, not below. Amen. God promised you, I will keep you as a head, not tail. God will put you above. How many of you believe that? God will bring every giant under your feet. You will stand upon the giant and you will remove the head. Amen. Head is the place, all the commands, all the thinking, all the ideas, all the theologies and everything comes from the head, right? The enemy throws the threatening against David. Goliath threatened him. Amen. Everything came from this head. Hallelujah. The same way, maybe you are thinking, there is a place. All the opposition comes from that place. Hallelujah. God will remove that place from your life. Amen. Wherever the challenge is coming against you, God will remove that place. Amen. Hallelujah. God remove the head of the Goliath. Amen. Because from that mind, from that brain, every threatening, every words of fear come against the people of God. Hallelujah. God will remove the root of the problem from your life. Amen. Hallelujah. David stood upon the child and he took off the head. Hallelujah. Later on, if you see, after David defeated giant Goliath, there was a great celebration and praises in the land of Jerusalem. Amen. The women started to praise David. They said, Saul killed 1,000, David killed 10,000. Hallelujah. Amen. This one challenge took David into the palace. Hallelujah. Few hours before, David was in the battlefield facing the giant Goliath. But after a few hours, everything changed. Everything changed. Goliath completely gone. David went to the palace. Hallelujah. God wants to encourage you. The challenges will take you to the right place. David was ordained as the king of Israel. Right? Are you listening? Yes. Okay. Before Goliath came, David was in the shepherd field. Right? But after he faced Goliath, the giant, his place was palace. Hallelujah. Challenges will take you to the higher places. Hallelujah. Because you put your trust in the Lord. Amen. Every giant will come and render you. You will be going to the right direction. Amen. David was ordained as a king. Because of this giant Goliath, God put him in the right track. Amen. Hey David, this is the right track. You need to go towards palace. No more shepherd field for you. Hereafter, palace is your place. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 So if you are facing Goliath, be encouraged. Very soon, God is going to put you in the right direction, right track. Whatever you call for, whatever you are ordained for, you will go towards that direction. That's why God allowed Goliath in your life. Not to defeat you, not to destroy you, not to keep you in the shepherd field. No, to take you to the higher places. Amen. Take you to the right direction. How many of you believe that? Amen. God is asking us, put your trust in my name. Do not lean on your own understanding. Lean on me. Hallelujah. 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 Very soon, he will bring every giant under your feet and he will put you in the right track. You will go in the right direction, whatever God has called you. Amen. That's why you are now facing the giant Goliath. Hallelujah. But over the night, it will change. If you believe, you will see the glory of God. Amen. Shall we all stand up?